So last IPCC report published last year states that we should reduce our CO2 emissions by 7% every year to meet the zero emissions objective by 2050 and to limit the global warming to 1.5 degrees. In addition to that, we have increasing expectations from the society to meet these goals, as you may have seen during last Madrid COP25. And there are also a growing number of initiatives within the scientific community to go toward a low carbon science. So the first step at BSC Earth Department is to calculate the carbon footprint. So yeah, the carbon footprint is to measure the greenhouse gases emitted by activities, research activities at the BSC Earth expressed in CO2 equivalent.
Okay, so to calculate the carbon budget, we group emissions into four main items, which are the commuting to get to BSC and back home, the computing infrastructure, building and all activities we do in the building, and travels. And here you can see the results, but you will have to guess what does each color represent. So we'll need you to raise your hands. And please raise your hands if you think that travels are the main source of CO2 emissions. Okay. Did you count? Then raise your hands if you think it's building. Not so many. So who thinks is computing the main contributor? Okay. And commuting to work? Okay. So there's a draw between computing and travels. And now you will learn. So we start with the commuting. Here on your left, you can see that we use all kinds of means of transportation to get to BSC. But in terms of emissions, on the right side, you see that 44% of the emissions correspond to private cars, although only 8% of people use private car. Whereas the 30% of people who walk or bike, they produce zero emissions, which is quite obvious. And the total for this item is 29 tons CO2 per year. And this is the smallest contributor to our emissions, so you guessed right, most of you. Next, building and infrastructures. And under this item, we have anything from electricity consumption for heating and AC, we have the furniture, internet activity, water, waste, and meals also. And you see that the main contributors in this item are electricity and meals, which account for 2/3 of the emissions. There's a lot of uncertainty in these calculations because we used conversion factors. And well, we have to improve on this. But the amount is about 120 tons CO2 per year. So this is the second smallest contributor to our emissions.
Okay, so now let's see about travel. So in 2018, which is the year we did this budget, we in the department, we did almost 300 trips. So 15% done in Spain, 75% in Europe, and about 10% are overseas travels. So here you can see the relative emissions associated. So of course, the plane consume much less CO2 than planes, so that's why the percentage of CO2 emissions related to Spain emissions is so low. But overseas trip, although they represent only 10% of travels, they represent 40% of the carbon budget. So they are really a high contributor. So this is the third emitters, main emitter of our carbon budget. So of course you may have guessed that with almost 0.5% of the total emissions, this is the computing infrastructure. This is mainly electricity. So we separated that into the storage part, which represents almost 2/3 of the electricity, and also the pure computing, mostly on Mare Nostrum, but also on the European Center computer. and also a small part concerning the CO2 associated with the installation and dismantle of the supercomputers. So we can expect that the TAPE system should significantly reduce our emissions, and of course this is highly dependent on the electric sources that are provided. So in total, it's almost 400 tons of carbon of CO2 equivalent. So in total, for the BSC Earth Department, we emitted about 800 tons of CO2 equivalent in year 2018. There was, in average, 80 people in the department. That leads to 10 tons of CO2 equivalent per year. So if we compare that, so this is only related to the work of these people. So if we compare that to Barcelona, the average is 2 tons of CO2, and for Spain and the average of the world is 5 tons of CO2 equivalent.
Okay, so what's next? Now we have this important piece of information, and we also have the template to update this annually, and we would also like to upscale the calculations to the whole center, to the whole BSC, which would take, of course, your collaboration. And we realized during this process that it would be very nice to make a few minor changes in the way we do the accounting of all our activities to improve the calculation of the carbon budget, increase the awareness, and also to decrease the uncertainty in the calculations, which is very big at present. And yep, so the logical next step would be to make a plan for reducing carbon dioxide emissions. But today we are not going to propose a detailed plan. But we will speculate a little bit. So imagine we used 100% renewable energies. This would cut our emissions by as much as 60%. And of course, we didn't mention the efficiency of the Mare Nostrum, for example, or the machines, because we know there is already a big effort on this aspect. And the second most effective way to cut emissions would be flying less. And we know there are good alternatives, like doing more video conferences, taking the train, and in particular with the new building, there is a good opportunity to improve the facilities to make video conferences, for example. So this is the end. We would like to thank all the people who helped us in these calculations, especially the management, human resources, and support for providing data and help in general, and also all the people who did this work on their little spare time. And this is the BSC Earth Carbon Footprint Team. Thank you.